Дали Берлинскиот процес може да биде замена за полноправното членство во Европската Унија?
No, the Berlin process is to design additional progress alongside the EU process of the Western Balkan countries. So if you look back 2014, what was the situation? President Juncker said that enlargement is not going to happen in the next couple of years. He also there was a crisis in Ukraine, a war, and the illegal annexation of Crimea. And in this, against this background, Angela Merkel invited the Western Balkans leaders to Berlin to discuss what can be done in addition to what Hahn and the European Commission are doing with the Western Balkan countries. But if you also look back, a couple of countries were blocked. Macedonia was blocked still in opening accession negotiations. The process between Serbia and Kosovo was still very difficult. Bosnia had its problems. So the overall situation was somehow blocked on the way to enlargement. So what we looked at, or what the governments looked at, both from the side of the European Union member states in the Berlin process, but also from the countries in the region, is what else can be done. Two things were important. One, of course, to look at what has been conflicts between the countries and can we deal with them. This is the key issue of the European Union, overcoming conflict in Europe. This is what Minister Alfano, the Italian foreign minister, just said. It's about peace. And here, of course, also there's a huge responsibility among the EU member states. If you look at the tensions between Greece and Macedonia, there's a lot of homework to be done within the EU as well to contribute to cooperation. Second thing is the youth dimension. I think we cannot underestimate the youth dimension. It's very good that there's more investment in young people, there's more investment in meetings, but also there must be more investment in training of young people, etc. And the third one is the famous connectivity agenda. Now, this one is, yes, it's important investments to do additional investments into infrastructure, but of course, infrastructure alone will not help. If you look back to the 1970s, when in Yugoslavia there was a big infrastructure boom, it doesn't help you to overcome the economic crisis, yet it can lay the foundations for, you know, faster moving, more kind of economic activity. So the three elements which I mentioned, there are things that need to be done anyway. You need to have friendly relations with your neighbors, you should invest into young people and in reconciliation, and thirdly, you should invest into infrastructure and connectivity. But here the Berlin process should provide additional support.
Но дали Берлинскиот процес и успеа да ги постигне резултатите кои што се очекуваа од него?
If you ask me, we all expected more from it. I think also the people in the region expected more from it. And this is maybe also gives you an idea why Minister Gabriel, the German foreign minister, made this announcement of a Berlin Plus. And the Berlin Plus is exactly to say, can we generate more support for the region? Can we generate maybe even more funding for the region? This is a very important discussion, which was also subject of discussion now here today, this morning, and it will be very, very difficult. Number one, the EU budget overall will shrink with the leaving of the United Kingdom by 15%. Number two, the Central Eastern European countries have not caught up sufficiently yet, so there will be a discussion about structural policies. And the ones who are outside the European Union, meaning the Western Balkan countries, will not be sitting at the table and negotiating the new multi-annual financial framework of the European Union. So the issue of money is a real one, because this is now the moment to say how much money should be invested into the region. And that's why I think the Berlin process should probably be looking not so much into a continuation of the Berlin process, but to bring the issues at the table when they're discussed in an EU framework. We will have a new institutional cycle starting in 2019. This is 2 years from now. And that will be the institutional cycle during which, in my view, the Western Balkans need to be almost ready, if not enter the European Union, which is by the end of 2026. If it's not managed in the next institutional cycle, I think we're looking probably at alternative forms of cooperation between the European Union and the Western Balkans, as you cannot have a promise outstanding for over 20 years for acceding to the European Union.
Дали тоа значи дека сте оптимист дека целиот регион еден ден ќе влезе во Европската Унија?
I would be very happy to be very optimistic, but if you look back into the region and the difficulties, you mentioned them, we have seen that a couple of difficulties are there. The behavior of the governments to each other is not always perfect. It is a lot of fear and there's a lot of concern within the European Union to not import problems. The problems of Cyprus and the unification of the island, which was hoped to be overcome by the accession to the European Union, just reminded us that there needs to be something more strong before you enter, that these kind of problems are solved. The problems between Kosovo and Serbia, these two countries will have to have an agreement and mutual recognition to move forward. The countries Kosovo and Serbia are linked to each other, and their problems are linked to each other, and these problems should be solved before they accede. Then there are, of course, these kind of new blockages, which unfortunately also involve EU member states. If you look at the role between Slovenia and Croatia, that these kind of difficulties, which should be solved amicably, are solved in a very emotional way, is nothing that bodes very well for future member states if they haven't brought the house in order. So the optimism is always on the side of there is homework to be done. There's a huge motivation, we know it's still in the population. There's a huge motivation also to develop economically, to develop these countries. So these things can come together in a good way, but it needs also a political breakthrough in the region, among the leaders of the region, in the countries themselves, to change the way how they do politics and move from confrontational politics into more cooperative politics and move from winner-takes-it-all attitudes to compromise and to look far more precisely on how actually they work on the welfare of their citizens and how they make their democracies work better.